Hello, folks. I have created this little mini-series about importing transactions into QuickBooks, and I have added it to the end of the Bank Feeds courses. That's because I want my students to have every possible option when deciding how to import transactions into QuickBooks and QuickBooks Online. So, in this little course, we will explore every option for QuickBooks Desktop and every option for QuickBooks Online regarding importing transactions. And in this particular video, I'm going to give you a little overview of what your options are so that you're aware of what the options are and you have some sense of what they are. Then, the four videos that follow this one will give you clear examples on how to utilize each of those four options. First, we'll talk about importing transactions in general. Lists are always easily imported. Lists are not transactions. When I say lists, I mean things like the chart of accounts, the customers, the vendors, and this type of thing. You know, they can be easily exported from one file and imported to another, and you absolutely do not need a video series to import customers or export product lists or services or anything like that. The challenging part of QuickBooks regarding transferring data is importing transactions. Now, third-party software is great. Third-party software does everything, but you have to pay for it in addition to paying for your QuickBooks. In my opinion, the best third-party software that you can buy for importing transactions into either QuickBooks or QuickBooks Online is Z-Access. If you use Z-Access, you can import both to QuickBooks Online and QuickBooks Desktop. And the great thing about this software is that you can record every last detail of every type of transaction. Now, I'm not trying to sell you Z-Access. I'm making this little video series to prove to you that Z-Access is not always necessary. You should explore the free options that are available that I'm explaining in this little mini-series before deciding to buy Z-Access or any third-party software program. Now, to import transactions into QuickBooks Desktop, there are only two options. You can buy and use the Accountant's Edition of QuickBooks Desktop, or you can use IFF files. Now, if you choose to import using the Accountant's Edition, this is really my recommendation. This is really my favorite one, and I can't imagine people not wanting to use this. You could upgrade from your QuickBooks Pro to the Accountant's Edition at approximately the same purchase price as it would be if you bought Z-Access. So instead of going and running out and buying a third-party software, just upgrade your QuickBooks to the Accountant's Edition, and it gives you the ability to import easily and smoothly. And like I said, the difference is the same amount as paying for Z-Access. But the good news is you will have all the other features of the Accountant's Edition, and sometimes those other features really come in handy. So you might want to explore buying the Accountant's Edition, or at least upgrading from your QuickBooks Pro instead of the one you have now, if importing transactions is very important to you. You should know that if you use the Accountant's Edition, more than 90% of the transactions that people commonly have can be imported very easily from Excel or any spreadsheet program. Any level of detail that does not import easily into the Accountant's Edition can be input manually. And if you have hundreds of these details, then your business is doing well enough to buy Z-Access or some third-party software. Now, the other option for a desktop is importing IIF files. Now, the great thing about IIF files is there's no need for special software. They're meant to be imported into QuickBooks. And the other great thing is it imports to every desktop version, whether you have QuickBooks Pro, the retail version, the accountant's edition, whatever. This file format will import transactions directly into QuickBooks. Another great thing is that it's possible to import every kind of transaction at every level of detail. So if you have transactions with a lot of detail, like what invoices have which payments applied, or which deposits have which receipts being deposited with that deposit, you know, you could use IIF files. But the problem with this type of method is that it involves lots of study time because it's kind of like programming. Usually it winds up taking longer than entering the transactions manually one by one. But the reason it's used is because large companies have programmers that can give you a file to import conveniently. In fact, in my example in the bank feeds, PayPal gives you an IIF file for free for your PayPal activity, and it imports right into any version of QuickBooks Desktop. All you have to do is clarify when you're done. But if you know IIF programming, you can put enough detail so that when you import, you don't have to clarify anything. It's ready to go. Now, importing transactions into QuickBooks Online has two other options, and both of these are imperfect. You can upload from the QuickBooks desktop version in one click. It's the easiest thing you'll ever do. Or you could use CSV files. The problem with CSV files is they're really meant for bank feeds, and if you're curious how they work, you have two options. You can look at the previous video towards the end of the bank feeds lesson, or you could wait for this lesson to show you again how to import transactions with CSV files. Now, if you upload from the QuickBooks desktop version, the problem is it will overwrite everything in the QBO account with everything that's on the desktop file, and it will do that every single time you upload the transactions. So even though it's the easiest and it's just one click and you put in your password, you keep losing whatever's up in the cloud in lieu of whatever happens to be in the QuickBooks file that you're uploading. And what's online is lost every time. But some people have both the desktop version and QuickBooks Online, and they do this to keep a record in the desktop version and just upload to the online version so they can log on and find things from remote locations. So you might say, well, why should I pay for that subscription every month? But some people, when they're on the go and they need to log into their information by using the internet, it might be better to pay a few dollars each month and have QuickBooks Online and just upload from your desktop just so that you can find things while you're out. Now, CSV files, again, CSV files can only import into the bank review section, and there are only three pieces of information that they can import into your QuickBooks Online: date, description, and amount. You must go through them one by one and reclassify and add detail. And those are your options. I promise you a very clear video explaining each of the four options and giving clear examples on how to apply them in the following four videos. Thank you for watching, and I wish you good luck importing your transactions.